Well, it is half past the hour here on the Weather Channel. I'm Alex Wallace.
And I'm Kelly Cass. We are live tracking a very dangerous situation, historic flooding that is going on in the state of Texas. And really, this shows you what the state's been dealing with as we take a look at some of the damage here. This is a high school in San Marcos that's located between Austin and San Antonio.
Yeah, officials actually evacuated the school, and well, you can see why. It was surrounded by water. The city under a boil water order because of today's flooding.
And obviously a lot of people had to evacuate and have been displaced as well. And of course, the Red Cross coming into the rescue, setting up shelters in parts of Texas.
And joining us now is Bristol Minksker with the Texas Red Cross flood response. And thanks so much, Bristol, for joining us here this evening. Can you give us an update on how many shelters have been set up?
We have about 8 shelters set up around the Central Texas area. That covers more than 5 counties, and it seems like we're opening more and shifting the locations every minute as needed as the weather situation worsens or changes.
Bristol, where's the worst of it, do you think? I mean, we've been tracking heavy rain and even the tornadoes across your state. It's been a rough day there.
It's been a very rough day, starting from early this morning with tornado warnings and tornado touchdowns. The worst of it seems to be centered along the I-35 corridor between Austin and San Antonio, where that's where most of our shelters are open. In southeast Austin, one of the communities that was really heavily flooded, where we actually have the highest shelter population now, was impacted almost 2 years ago today on Halloween of 2013 with a terrible flood. So many of the families are the exact same families that lost their homes 2 years ago. And many of the families in the San Marcos area were impacted by the floods we had on Memorial Weekend this past spring. So it's really been a difficult day as the community really pulls together and tries to just get through these severe weather conditions.
Oh, absolutely. I can't even imagine. Just a tough situation there. Do you have an estimate on how many people have sought shelter?
We've got more than 200 people staying across all of our shelters right now. And as I mentioned, the numbers seem to keep growing as more people realize that their homes are not a safe place to stay. And we've got some more rain falling this evening. So we may see that increase even more.
I think I saw a report, Bristol, of even a shelter being evacuated earlier today. Do you know anything about that?
That's right. There was a shelter in San Marcos that they decided to move it to another location, move all the residents over to another location because the floodwaters were rising and they were worried that it would no longer be a safe place to use as a shelter. So unfortunately, that's not uncommon because the flash floods here in Central Texas are so dangerous and the situations can change so quickly. So we have to remain really nimble and be ready to change on a moment's notice.
Bristol, all these shelters that are set up, are they pet friendly?
Generally, we don't have pets in the shelter staying overnight with the residents for various safety reasons, but what we do is partner with other agencies. So anyone who brings their pet to the shelter, there'll be another room or a neighboring building where there are kennels set up and the pets can stay there safely overnight and the owners of the pets can go check on them, feed them, walk them. So they're co-located, but they don't stay overnight in the same dormitory with the residents.
Unfortunately, Bristol, we're still looking at an active radar picture out there. What about people who are watching right now who want to know how they can get help if they do need it?
They can certainly go to redcross.org or call 1-800-RED-CROSS for the most recent shelter locations. We encourage people to follow Centex Red Cross on Twitter because we're posting updates by the minute as we change and offer more assistance to the community that's been impacted.
All right, Bristol Minksker with the Texas Red Cross flood response. We certainly appreciate you chatting with us, and we appreciate all that you and the organization does.
Absolutely, Bristol. Thank you so much. Carl Parker here in the lab with us to talk about the scope, the magnitude of this flood event that we saw, Carl. And you heard Bristol just talk about, you know, it was just a few months ago in the spring when we had a terrible flood.
Yeah, you know, and just last week we had a huge problem there in Corsicana in Central Texas. So we've had a lot of this year. And let's take a look at the 12-hour radar loop to show you exactly how it went down in the hill country. You notice that there was rain in the early part of this loop around Austin, between Austin and San Antonio, that just sat over the same areas for several hours. There was a warm front there, so as moisture was moving in from the Gulf of Mexico, it was being lifted right along that boundary and really just did not move. Now, that heavy rain has lifted up and weakened considerably. We've got a line of storms now coming through the Metroplex. Not a lot of impact there, but there is is more development now off to the west. The big upper feature that's producing all this wet weather is still now well to the west. And so we've got more rounds of rain on the way for a lot of the state. And the southeastern part of the state really could be under the gun for more flash flooding. There's the 12-hour rainfall, very large area, more than 3 inches of rainfall. These are some of the same areas that were walloped just a week ago. Corsicana there, Navarro County, south of Dallas. And then you also see right in here around Austin, that was the area that was really the epicenter of the very worst flooding today. San Marcos getting 16 inches of rain and more than 14 inches there in Austin. As a result, we saw flash flooding. Here's what we call a hydrograph. So we're going out in time on the right there and showing you the level of the Guadalupe River, very popular river for tubing near New Braunfels. And you see how quickly that went up and crested well into major stage at 22 feet. That is the very definition of a flash flood when it comes up that fast. But then it came down very quickly as well, now back down to 3.55 feet. Also looking at the Onion Creek there, Driftwood, similarly very quickly up to 26 feet, well above major stage and above record stage, a new record set there, and now back down to nearly minor stage. So things are improving. We notice there are ongoing flash flood warnings. There's been some wet weather, but that's now beginning to move out. But again, we do have concerns about what's going to be developing farther west, including now some severe weather that is well off to the west of 37. There's a look at Edwards, Real, and Uvalde counties under warning. Campwood, watch out for some damaging wind. We did have a report of 80-mile-per-hour wind with that cell, and that is generally going to be moving towards the Route 83 corridor. And again, we've got some storms that are now coming through the Metroplex. There are no warnings on these. We may see some wind, possibly some rain, but at least right now it's not looking like it's going to be a huge deal there in the Metroplex. So here's the upper low moisture coming into the low levels, moisture coming in the mid levels of the atmosphere, all that slowly translating across the Lone Star State through tonight. We'll look at the model going forward. We're going to want to pay very close attention to southeast Texas, in particular between Houston and Beaumont and Lake Charles. We expect to see a lot of rain there overnight tonight. Here's that new rain coming into the hill country, so it could be some exacerbation of that existing flooding there in the hill country. And then you've got more heavy rain from Shreveport back down into Houston, even into tomorrow morning. It won't quite be done, Kelly, even into tomorrow morning in southeast Texas, but finally clearing out of that I-35 corridor, we think, during tomorrow morning. Back to you.
Have a way to get those warnings during the overnight hours. Carl, thank you so much. And we're talking devastating impacts really from this flooding. Here's what we know at this hour. At least one death in Travis County, a driver in Austin. Officials believe he may have been swept away while he was sitting on top of his car waiting for rescue. Now, at least two others are still missing at this hour, so they are still looking for them in the Austin area, where, as Carl mentioned, we picked up well over 14 and a half inches of rain. The mayor of New Braunfels has declared a disaster declaration for his town in San Marcos, and also that city under a boil water advisory as a result of all the flooding. In fact, that advisory may hold all the way through the weekend and into early next week as well. So pay attention to the officials there if you live in San Marcos, Texas. All right, we've got flood watches in effect, including Bexar County there in San Antonio, right down towards Brownsville. We've had some dangerous lightning with these storms as well. And as Carl mentioned, we will eventually see that rain and get out of Texas as we head into the weekend. But look at the heavy rain breaking out in parts of Mississippi, Alabama. Here it comes into Atlanta, Georgia as well. And right along the beaches of Florida, it looks like it's going to be a stormy time for Sunday. Of course, the day after Halloween. So tonight it's all about Texas, but it gets worse for other areas.
Currently in our area, 78 degrees under fair skies. Tonight, clear to partly cloudy, low 73. Winds light and variable. Saturday, sunshine and clear. Saturday night, clear skies with a few passing clouds, low 73. Winds east at 5 to 10 miles per hour. Here's our 7-day outlook.
love you.
Love you too.
One minute. Hi. We need to do this, yes.
Letting go.
I'll say a word.
It's a little easier when you've saved for college with State Farm. And just like that, it's a whole new world outside. And jackets come out of hibernation. And we can feel the air. We can see it too. And we gear up and layer up and zip up. And we make the most of the new season. Because when the world is at its coldest, we're at our warmest. L.L. Bean. Guaranteed season after season.
If you have moderate to severe plaque psoriasis, isn't it time to let the real you shine through? Introducing Otezla, apremilast. Otezla is not an injection or a cream. It's a pill that treats plaque psoriasis differently. Some people who took Otezla saw 75% clearer skin after 4 months. And Otezla's prescribing information has no requirement for routine lab monitoring. Don't take Otezla if you are allergic to any of its ingredients. Otezla may increase the risk of depression. Tell your doctor if you have a history of depression or suicidal thoughts or if these feelings develop. Some people taking Otezla reported weight loss. Your doctor should monitor your weight and may stop treatment. Side effects may include diarrhea, nausea, upper respiratory tract infection, and headache. Tell your doctor about all the medicines you take and if you're pregnant or planning to be. Ask your doctor about Otezla today. Otezla. Show more of you.
Bridgestone's new DriveGuard tires are engineered to take a puncture and go up to 50 miles.
We can drive 50 miles on a flat, and you have an app that makes nails pop up.
Yep.
We could rule the world. But I've got carpool at 3, though, so
that time.
We could, like, mess with the world. La, 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 la,
la, la, la, la. Tonight we come to let loose. Tonight we come to dance. They try to put us in a box. They try to categorize us the same. We gotta dress like this. We gotta talk like that. Say no more. Spirit use a wing. Tonight we change things.
Freedom. Freedom.
It's Olive Garden's 20th anniversary of Never Ending Pasta Bowl. So we're celebrating by offering you over 20 delicious choices starting at $9.99. Like creamy new pesto Alfredo or crispy chicken Frida. Plus unlimited salad and breadsticks for a limited time at Olive Garden.
When your cold makes you wish you could stay in bed all day, you need the power of new Theraflu Express Max. New Theraflu Express Max, the power to feel better.
If you don't think beat con men at their own game when you think AARP, you don't know ARP. The AARP Fraud Watch Network helps everyone protect themselves and their families against scams and identity theft. Find more real possibilities at aarp.org/possibilities.
Today we're getting record snowfall.
Radars indicate there's been flooding throughout the area.
We're getting hail the size of golf balls.
Maglite. Turn your light on, America.
That's right. These storms also packing lightning.
Wow. And as you just saw and heard, the lightning actually hit a Doppler radar tower in Brownsville, Texas earlier today. This is in extreme far southern Texas, right near the border with Mexico.
Wow. I mean, you could feel it.
I know. I think that radar is still out of operation.
Yeah.
Right?
Wow.
So
unreal.
You can see why.
Well, you know, visitors and residents alike stunned by the storms that we've seen today and the damage that they've caused.
And when it comes to today's tornadoes in Texas, this is the iconic image, really. A tractor trailer just lifted from a nearby road and tossed on its side, and even part of it going up onto a roof on a nearby hotel.
I mean, that is unbelievable here. And of course, we're going to figure out, the National Weather Service offices are going to be heading out there to figure out what caused this. But regardless, who cares what caused it?
Mm-hmm.
You see what happened, and it is amazing to show you the power of what wind can do.
It really is. But we have our own expert right here in the house as well. Severe weather expert Dr. Greg Forbes pieced together what could have happened in this situation and suggested just how strong this tornado might be in a discussion with our own Ray Stajic.
Clearly a tractor trailer, a semi had been hit somewhere adjacent to that hotel there. You see now as they pan out some a lot of trucks and buildings there off to the right of the hotel where's probably where the tornado hit. Maybe the tractor trailer was on that road there, was picked up, tossed in the air, and then centrifuged out of the tornado, hurled out of the tornado circulation. The tractor trailer unable to follow the tight counterclockwise winds around the tornado and landed on the roof. Clearly not a tremendous amount of damage there to the hotel that we could see, but I would think that we're talking about probably at least an EF2 tornado damage somewhere in the adjacent areas to this. The National Weather Service will go out and examine and find the strongest type of structure. There is not, by the way, a way to rate a tornado based upon just the tossing of tractor trailers like that, so they'll have to look at structures that were hit by it in the vicinity of where the tractor trailer may have been.
Right, Greg. Any possibility that, are we definitely thinking tornado here, or could straight line winds or something else do something to that magnitude?
Well, typically straight line winds, when they're straight line winds, the winds are coming downward. So usually they don't have that kind of lifting that would have lifted a tractor trailer up two or three stories high. So I'm 99% sure that had to have been done by a tornado, which does have that inflowing winds. And then in addition to the counterclockwise rotation, it has those strong upward going winds, and that's what can pick up vehicles, pick up things as big as a tractor trailer and toss it through the air.
Wow. Well, I'll tell you, Floresville, just one of the places where an apparent tornado struck today in Texas. DeHannes and Geronimo, just southeast of San Marcos, dealt with possible tornadoes as well. And possible tornadoes were also reported 3 miles east northeast of Hunter there in Hays County and 8 miles west of Caldwell in Burleson County. Now, Kelly's standing by to pinpoint where the severe weather concern is now and as we head into the weekend.
Yeah, because we still have a severe thunderstorm watch in effect here in extreme western Texas. It does not include San Antonio, but it goes until 2 o'clock in the morning. So make sure you've got a way to get those warnings and wake you up in case you either have a severe warning or even a tornado warning, because you can't rule out tornadoes even in this situation. Now, we do have thunderstorms going from Dallas right on back towards San Angelo. We have got some severe thunderstorm warnings also in effect where we have our present severe thunderstorm watch. I want to zoom in on Dallas first of all, because look at that heavy rain that's marching its way towards Dallas. We've already had some downpours in Fort Worth. We've got a ground stop at the airport because of the thunderstorm in the vicinity. But as we go west of Fort Worth, this is where we do have a severe thunderstorm warning just issued moments ago. This is south of I-20, southeast of Abilene. We've got Callahan and Coleman counties now under a severe thunderstorm warning until 9:15 central, so watch out in the Cross Plains area. We've been watching this storm as well. This storm has produced 80 mile per hour winds, so we still have a problem with this one around the Brackettville area as it continues to move toward the east at 30 miles per hour. Seek shelter. Alex?
All right. Well, these storms in Texas causing misery for some who are unfortunately no stranger to the damage flooding can do.
But this community's strong. I mean, there's no question that this was a gut shot. Yeah, you know, to have something like this happen as quickly after the May disaster. But this community's strong, it's resilient, and it'll bounce back rather quickly.
Well, what this latest flooding has done in the community of Wimberley, we have that story next.
So what about that stock? Sure thing, right?
Actually, knowing the kind of risk that you're comfortable with, I'd steer clear.
Really?
Really.
Straight talk.
Now, based on your strategy, I do have some other thoughts.
Multiplied by 13,000 financial advisors, it's a big deal. And it's how Edward Jones makes sense of investing.
How to make an awesome weather science show. Take three scientists.
That's us.
A scientist.
Yeah. They know that.
Add the forces of nature.
Ooh, that's hot stuff.
Mix in some crazy experiments.
Lit my hand on fire.
Why?
Because of science.
Oh, that is so cool.
And then...
Go! Who said science isn't fun?
Three scientists walk into a bar. Bottoms up Sunday nights at 10 on the Weather Channel. And join the community now on Facebook.com/threescientists.
Currently in our area, 78 degrees under fair skies. Tonight, clear to partly cloudy, low 73. Winds light and variable. Saturday, sunshine and clouds mixed. High 84. Winds east-northeast at 10 to 15 miles per hour. Saturday night, clear skies with a few passing clouds. Low 73. Winds east at 5 to 10 miles per hour. Here's our 7-day outlook.
Travels towards an intersection with wipers that streak and clog, while another travels towards the same intersection with wiper blades that don't let them see clearly. But between them, the Michelin Man with Michelin Stealth Wiper Blades, a revolution in wiper blade technology, combining SmartFlex construction for superior windshield contact with proven hybrid blade design for clog-free performance in rain, ice, and snow, helping you steer clear for the road ahead. Michelin Stealth Wiper Blades, a better way forward. Get your Michelin wiper blades at these fine retailers.
Gentlemen, quality comes at a price, a very affordable price. All executive suits are now $179, and all traveler suits are $279. Plus, all executive sport coats and blazers are now $149. Only at Joseph A. Bank.
It's your thing.
See results in just 1 week with SlimFast. Shake it off. Blend it off. Just take it off and keep it off. Rich, protein-packed SlimFast controls hunger up to 4 hours. SlimFast, it's your thing.
With our totally unique and incredibly successful approach, chances are that behind every great relationship, there's eHarmony.com. Stop waiting. Start communicating for...
Wherever you go, your favorite shows and movies should go with you. With Xfinity, you can take all of your DVR shows to go.
So I don't have to wait till I get home.
That's right.
Now you can watch your favorites anywhere.
Which would be super handy.
Let's say you want to watch your favorite shows in the park.
Lovely day.
Watch some people exercise.
Or you could be at the beach.
Yeah. Oh, man, this is awesome.
Xfinity is perfect for people on the go. Upgrade to an Xfinity X1 Triple Play from Comcast and save when you bundle. See for yourself. Call 1-800-XFINITY or visit Xfinity.com today.
Tired of hearing yes all the time?
Yes, you need a down payment. Yes, you have to buy tires and batteries for your vehicle.
At Best Med Kia, we love to say no. No money down. No, you never have to buy tires and batteries. New Sorrentos, zero down, $299 a month. New Optimas, zero down, $249 a month. Plus, every new Best Med Kia comes with free tires and batteries for life. Isn't it great to hear no every now and then? Get to Best Med Kia today and then say yes.
Love at first bite. Thursdays on the Weather Channel. When nature is this dangerous, only one question matters.
Oh my God!
So you think you'd survive? Thursdays at 10, only on the Weather Channel.
Welcome back as we take a live look. Dallas here for us, a spot with a line of showers and storms just on off towards the west. You can see it's a rather gray time, clouds hanging very low. Airport issues as well, ground stops in place as well. So you're not going anywhere anytime soon there in and around Dallas. So an unfortunate situation there taking place and all across the Lone Star State. Of course, today has been just an incredible mess. We still have ongoing storms out there. In fact, right now, severe thunderstorm watch is in place here until 2 o'clock in the morning. It's just west of San Antonio. Del Rio, you are included in that. Uvalde as well. And we've been watching some storms that have been rolling on through, including this particular storm, which is certainly meant business. Severe thunderstorm warning in place here. The storm itself just north of Camp Wood until 9:30 Central Time. This storm producing 82 mile per hour wind gusts. So yeah, this thing certainly means business as it's tracking its way now on off towards the east northeast. And then Austin, for you, the heavy rain has shifted away, but we are still under a flash flood warning. That's in place until 10:15. Kelly?
Well, Alex, we now know that two people have died in this historic Texas flooding, one in Austin, the other in the San Antonio area. The storm that brought the floodwaters started early today in Texas, and as they continue to rumble across the state, they leave behind a trail of damage from flooding and possible tornadoes. NBC's Erica Edwards recaps some of it.
Near Austin, roads turned to rivers Friday as a powerful storm system dumped more than 6 inches of rain an hour. Flash flood swept one woman's car away. She was pulled to safety from the rising waters by passersby.
I turned around and then I got sucked in.
A flooded parking lot turned pumpkin patch sent hundreds of pumpkins floating down a road. In San Antonio, officials reported more than a dozen road closures Friday morning as the weather pattern soaked the already saturated area. Before dawn, the weather system triggered possible tornadoes in the town of Floresville near Austin. In the daylight and from the air, the path of destruction could be seen for miles. Among the hardest hit, the local high school, where parts of the roof and several walls were ripped apart. Twisters strong enough to toss the steel base of a mobile home onto the roof of a nearby hotel. Another possible tornado hit Tejanas, ripping apart several buildings in the small Texas town. Crews spent the day working to restore power to the hard-hit areas as the cleanup from the powerful storms begins. Erica Edwards, NBC News.
That right there certainly gives you an overview of some of the damage that we've seen so far today.
But one important thing to remember is that this really is the second round of fierce flooding this year in Central Texas. We may recall over Memorial Day weekend, we had torrential rain sending the Blanco River out of its banks where, you know, communities like Wimberley were hit hard.
Yeah, absolutely. And then today, floodwater struck again in the Central Texas community.
The National Guard, it looked like, and the fire department showed up, and the bottom floor had 4 feet, maybe 4.5 feet of water, and so they made a human chain and used rope and roped us up, and then when the torrent was where it was really bad, they kind of pushed us towards the other person.
Yeah.
Because it was fast enough that it swept your feet out from underneath you, and you're just kind of free floating, holding onto the rope, and then they grabbed you and dragged you up to the other side.
Well, Wimberley, Texas, they're especially stunned by this latest round of flooding.
Yeah, the community was hit so very hard almost 5 months ago, and a lot of people are still trying to rebuild after the flooding that we saw over Memorial Day weekend. That was when we had at least 27 people dying in Central Texas after relentless rain sent the Blanco River and other waterways out of their banks. The tidal wave of water that resulted swept blocks of homes away. Wimberley and much of Hays County were especially hard hit, and now they're dealing with flooding and its aftermath yet again.
Wow, this historic flooding in Texas, just the latest example of what has been a truly wild week.
Yeah, a week of record-setting high tides. We had destructive and damaging winds, and yes, plenty of rain.
Just like the wind was going to blow you over.
I mean, the winds have been nuts.
You can really see just how rough this surf is and how nasty, too. That is an angry ocean right there. Great example of how you don't know what's under the road. Either they drove off the road or part of the road gave out.
Were you frightened?
Oh, yeah. Yes, I was.
Oh, my God!
Currently in our area, 78 degrees under fair skies. Tonight, clear to partly cloudy, low 73. Winds light and variable. Saturday, sunshine and clouds mixed, high 84. Winds east-northeast at 10 to 15 miles per hour. Saturday night, clear skies with a few passing clouds, low 73. Winds east at 5 to 10 miles per hour. Here's our 7-day outlook.
Sirens wail, warning of flood emergencies in Texas. tornadoes too.
Yeah, we're talking more than a foot of rain falling in some places, stranding people on top of cars, forcing evacuations from homes and schools, and the rain will not stop.
On the way, the devastating toll storms are taking right now on the state of Texas and where those storms could be headed next this weekend. Our special report, historic Texas flooding. I'm Alex Wallace.
And I'm Kelly Cass. You know, for the second time this month, flooding rain is lashing one state, Texas, and it looks like it's going to continue to be that threat right into the overnight hours. And we now know that it has proven deadly.
Yeah, officials at Camp Bullis near San Antonio have recovered the body of a flood victim. And in Travis County, Austin's home county, police found a driver who died in high water, apparently sitting on the top of his car, waiting for rescue.
We saw numerous high water rescues, and we're seeing some of the video now. Just incredible.
Yeah, a person who sent this in says that a small dam broke in the greater Austin area, sending water gushing.
And scenes like this being played out over several areas in Texas throughout the day as storms kept pouring rain over the area. Local media reports at least two people are still missing in the Austin area, and the state remains under at least portion of western Texas under a severe thunderstorm watch until 2 o'clock in the morning central time.
Now, we've seen cars underwater, and there's been dozens of water rescues reported today following this record rain there in Texas.
The Weather Channel's Gary Cooper surveyed the damage in two Texas cities and has more now from San Marcos, Texas.
More than a foot of rain fell in parts north and west of San Marcos and New Braunfels and throughout central Texas in an area known as the Hill Country. And the thing is, when so much rain falls on the Hill Country, well, all that water's got to go somewhere, and it goes through tributaries and streams and rivers that flow through San Marcos, and you have scenes like this. That is a delivery truck that weighs about 6 to 8 tons, depending on what's inside of it, and it just couldn't make it through the rushing waters here just outside downtown San Marcos. We're told the driver is okay, but the delivery truck, I should say, well, it's going to be there for a while. Now, again, more than a foot of rain fell in less than 24 hours. Most of it fell this morning, causing a lot of flash flooding in and around central and south Texas. We've been told that parts of San Marcos, Texas, are under a boil water notice, and even more tragically, we've learned that two persons have died as a result of this flash flooding. One person just south of Austin and another person just northwest of San Antonio near the Camp Bullis area. But more rain is forecasted to hit this part of central Texas, and folks here are a bit antsy. They have floods on their mind, especially from Memorial Day weekend, but they say they're certainly ready for whatever Mother Nature has in store for them. In San Marcos, reporting for the Weather Channel, I'm Gary Cooper. Back to you.
Gary, thank you. We want to get the latest now on the storms because they're still going on right now.
Yeah, absolutely. So let's bring in our storm specialist, Carl Parker. And Carl, I tell you, earlier in the year, we were dealing with the drought in Texas. We pretty much got rid of that. And then it started to creep back. But now we're probably going to get a little bit of help. But it's unfortunately the price we had to pay.
You know, it's amazing how much turnaround that we've seen here, because we went from having a drought earlier in the year to completely getting rid of it by the summer. And then late in the summer, going into the fall, we got drought back. About 50% of the state was in drought. And now we'll probably see much of the state not having any drought at all after this next event. So it's really been sort of a whipsaw back and forth in terms of evaporation in hot weather and getting all that moisture out of the ground, and then also over the oceans, putting a lot more water vapor in the atmosphere. And as a result, when it rains, it really, really comes down. So this is what happened in the last 12 hours. Not as widespread a rain event as we saw last week, but certainly a large area of very heavy rain. And then there were some spots within that where we got just devastated. Look at this. It's a very large area of several inches of rain there. When you zoom down into the Austin metro area, going right across 290 and 77, and then within that, we had some individual values of 16 inches plus, Austin getting more than 14 inches of rain. So a terrific amount of wet weather in a relatively short amount of time. In fact, Austin got almost 6 inches in 1 hour. So there's the current picture, and there are still flash flood warnings along the I-35 corridor because we've still got water running off. Creek levels are still up, although many of them have come way down as compared to what we saw earlier today. We did get some additional rain, and now the concern is what is developing off to the west here. There is a severe storm that's well off to the west of I-10 and 37. And a warning along with that for Real and Uvalde counties going until 9:30. Watch out in Leakey as there could be some damaging wind as that moves in. Also, a line of storms now across the Metroplex. Not a lot of severe threat with these storms. We've seen no warnings so far, but you notice there is some heavier rain here, and you've got a lot of impervious surfaces, obviously, in the Metroplex, a lot of concrete. And as a result, there could be some spotty flooding. Certainly, the feeder roads may fill up, that type of thing. We're going to take a look at where we go from here coming up in just a moment, but I want to talk about some of the players in this particular event. One big one, of course, is the low-level moisture coming in from the Gulf of Mexico, so a terrific amount of that. But it's not only that low-level moisture, it's also mid-level moisture, and we've been watching unusually warm ocean waters in general, and then also because of El Nino. So on top of that, you've got unusually warm and humid air in the atmosphere showing up right here, and so that was grabbed up by this upper low, which is sitting there and pulled in, and for that reason you have what's called deep layer moisture, a lot of moisture in several levels of the atmosphere, and then we've got this very slow moving upper low that's moving in and producing a lot of lift across the state of Texas. So we're not out of the woods yet. We've got a long way to go, and this is the model forecast showing you more rain coming into southeast Texas through the overnight hours into tomorrow morning and even into the afternoon in some areas, and more flood concerns. Kelly, over to you.
Carl, thank you. And this day of relentless rain and storms have had numerous impacts. Here's what we know at this hour. At least two people have died in the flooding, one in Austin, the other near San Antonio. Local media reports at least two other people are still missing in the greater Austin area. And due to storms right now, we've got ground stops in place. We're talking averaging 2.5 hour delays in the Dallas area as well. So do check ahead if you are doing any traveling here. Now, a gauge near Austin's airport recorded more than 13 inches of rain before it failed. And we want to see where that rain is still going on. We still have that flash flood warning in Austin. Now your second wettest year on record, your wettest month ever in the Austin-Bergstrom area. So fortunately, by the time we get towards the afternoon tomorrow, we will see that clearing trend from Dallas to Austin. But watch out. That system heads east. Louisiana, Mississippi, Alabama into Georgia. Second half of the weekend, it is really going to pour in these areas.
Why do we insist on 100% Alaskan whitefish? Why do we always hand dip in our famous batter, cook it to golden perfection, and serve it with fries for just $1.99? Because at Long John Silver's, we think you deserve more for $1.99. La, la, la,
la, la, la, la, la, la. Tonight we come to let loose. Tonight we come to dance. They try to put us in a box. They try to categorize us the same. We gotta dress like this. We gotta talk like that. But we say no more. Spirit, use your wings. Tonight we change things.
Freedom. Freedom.
Quiet! Mom has a headache.
Had a headache. But now, I don't. Excedrin is fast.
In fact, for some, relief starts in just 15 minutes. Excedrin, now available in gel tabs.
This is Henry. Expertise, staining carpet. It is his life's work. He is relentless. He is resourceful. But this is new LifeProof carpet from the Home Depot. With stain-resistant technology built in to help keep tough stains out. Checkmate, Henry. Let's do this. Save 10% on any carpet purchase when you use your Home Depot consumer credit card. Only at the Home Depot.
Here, once-in-a-lifetime experiences are for the taking. Meet the concierge team that provides luxury at its peak.
They want Jim to give the guinea pig a massage.
And they're serious.
Our job is to literally blow people's minds.
Opry Ski premieres Monday night at 10. Only by Bravo.
Currently in our area, 78 degrees under fair skies. Tonight, clear to partly cloudy, low 73. Winds light and variable. Saturday, sunshine and clouds mixed, high 84, winds east-northeast at 10 to 15 miles per hour. Saturday night, Clear skies with a few passing clouds. Low 73. Winds east at 5 to 10 miles per hour. Here's our 7-day outlook.
Are pouring in. See why people love Three Scientists Walk Into a Bar. Sunday nights at 10 on the Weather Channel.
After 50 years of designing cars for crash survival, Subaru has developed our most revolutionary feature yet. A car that can see trouble and stop itself to avoid it. When the Insurance Institute for Highway Safety tested front crash prevention, nobody beat Subaru models with EyeSight. Not Honda, not Ford, or any other brand. Subaru EyeSight. An extra set of eyes every time you drive.
It's your thing.
See results in just 1 week with SlimFast. Shake it off. Blend it off. Just take it off and keep it off. Rich, protein-packed SlimFast controls hunger up to 4 hours. SlimFast. It's your thing.
Lowe's presents How to Be Good at Math.
How much money do you think we saved today?
A lot.
Now get 10% off major appliances, $396 and more.
I never seen anything like this before. I mean, I live on the ocean. We have hurricanes, we have nor'easters, but I've never seen water run like this. It's amazing.
Amazing indeed, and just some of the reaction across Texas tonight to the historic flooding in the state. And it's not just flooding. Yeah, tornadoes have struck parts of the state as well, including in the town of Floresville. High school student Jake Lamberth tells us what happened.
My name is Jake Lamberth. I go to Post High School. This morning I woke up around 5 when the storm was rolling in, walked through the downtown area, and we just noticed all this debris and power lines, and just it was shocking. It's real shocking. 400 wing of Floresville, the roof had caved in. The front part of the school, there's a big hole in it from the debris and everything. And then the front statue of the school is in pieces. I approached the Holiday Inn and I saw an RV, which is, I kind of blinked twice. There was moderate, kind of severe damage to the Holiday Inn on the left side of it. And then there's a little bit of debris on the right side of it. I couldn't believe it.
Yeah, hard to believe, that is for sure. Now, Floresville, just one of the places where an apparent tornado struck today in Texas. DeHaenis and Geronimo, just southeast of San Marcos, dealt with possible tornadoes as well. And possible tornadoes were also reported 3 miles east-northeast of Hunter in Hays County and 8 miles west of Caldwell in Burleson County. Now we got Kelly standing by to pinpoint where the severe weather concern is now and as we head into the weekend.
Yeah, for now, Alex, we're still concerned about these counties in extreme western Texas, including Del Rio, just to the west of San Antonio. This is a severe thunderstorm watch that takes us to 2 o'clock in the morning local time. So just be mindful of that. We've already had reported winds gusting over 80 miles per hour with a couple of those storms. Lightning is also a danger. You can see that line pressing through the Dallas Metroplex all the way back towards San Angelo and just to the west of San Antonio. We are currently tracking some of that severe weather. We zoom on into the Austin area. We're starting to see a few showers developing, fairly light, but remember the ground is already saturated. I'm sure the floodwaters are already out there as well. It takes a while for those to come back down, especially some of the creeks that are out of their banks. We've got that boil water advisory for San Marcos because the water has been compromised. And you can see in the Dallas area continues to pour. And we've got ground stops at both airports right now. So you can see very heavy rain, nothing severe about these thunderstorms that are moving through right now. But still, that's going to slow you down a little bit on I-20. You head out 20 west of Fort Worth and you run into this area where we do have a severe thunderstorm warning. Looks like another one just issued just to the east of that around Callahan County till 9:15 central time. There could be winds in excess of 60 miles per hour. So definitely watch out for that. There could be a little bit of hail with that as well. Watch out for some nickel size hail with this storm and also the potential for 70 mile per hour winds. We're talking Real and Uvalde County. counties until 9:30 Central Time, just to the north of the Camp Wood area. And this is the storm that does have a history of producing significant wind. I mean, look at Brackettville. We're talking 82 mile per hour winds. That is enough to do some damage, knock down some trees, knock down some power lines as well. So know where those flashlights are just in case. Flash flood warning still in effect for the greater Austin area south of Waco as well. So even though the rain may not be coming down hard anymore, we still have the flood waters to deal with. Severe storms are going to be out there between Texas, Louisiana, and Mississippi tomorrow. And we can't rule out the possibility of some tornadoes in this area either, Alex.
All right. Well, you know, some are facing quite a cleanup job after all these storms. Case in point, the community of DeHaenas, Texas. And you can see roofs reduced to kindling here. And if possible, tornadoes didn't cause damage. Flooding rain certainly did. On the way, more of the best video.
You drop 40 grand on a new set of wheels, then wham, a minivan T-bones you. Guess what? Your insurance company will only give you $37,000 to replace it. Depreciation, they claim. How can my car depreciate before its first oil change, you ask? Maybe the better question is, why do you have that insurance company?
With Liberty Mutual New Car Replacement, we'll replace the full value of your car. See car insurance in a whole new light. Liberty Mutual Insurance.
Bridgestone is changing the game in tire performance.
So Will Arnett can get to the store when he's out of diapers.
Well, to be clear, they're not for me. For my son. So
we should probably go.
We switched Will's tires to Bridgestone's revolutionary Drive Guard tires.
Oh, those look sharp.
It's okay. Our Drive Guard tires are engineered to take a puncture and drive up to 50 miles on a flat. So no side of the road.
Well, that's good because the side of the road is dangerous, especially since we're going commando.
We're?
What commando mean?
Expose the black beneath the white. In light of day, dark of night. When winter shuts down work and schools, come with resolve. Powerful tools. Endure through every push, salt, and stack until your streets are back to black.
Don't miss Ace's biggest ever buy two, get one free LED sale now through Sunday. Buy any two select LED bulbs and get one free. Mix and match from our best-selling, longest-lasting LED bulbs and get over 80% in energy savings.
Ace is the place with the helpful hardware, folks.
Take in the sounds from all sides of an orchestra performing entirely for you. The Jeep Grand Cherokee. With active noise cancellation to turn any street into a symphony. Get 0% APR financing on the 2015 Jeep Grand Cherokee for well-qualified buyers, plus $500 Jeep Celebration bonus cash. The most awarded, rewarding SUV ever.
Coughing, sniffling, and wishing you could stay in bed all day. When your cold is this bad, you need new Theraflu Express Max. Theraflu Express Max combines maximum strength medicines available without a prescription to fight your worst cold and flu symptoms, so you can feel better fast and get back to the job at hand. New Theraflu Express Max, the power to feel better.
How to make an awesome weather science show. Take three scientists.
That's us.
Yeah, scientists. Yeah. They know that.
Add the forces of nature.
Ooh, that's hot stuff.
Mix in some crazy experiments.
Lit my hand on fire.
Why?
Because of science.
Oh, that is so cool.
And then...
go!
Who said science isn't fun?
Three scientists walk into a bar. Bottoms up Sunday nights at 10 on the Weather Channel. And join the community now on Facebook.com.
You pay your car insurance premium like clockwork, month after month, year after year. Then one night, you hydroplane into a ditch. Yeah. Surprise, your insurance company tells you to pay up again. Why pay for insurance if you have to pay even more for using it?
If you have Liberty Mutual Deductible Fund, you could pay no deductible at all. Sign up to immediately lower your deductible by $100 and keep lowering it $100 annually until it's gone. Then continue to earn that $100 every year. There's no limit to how much you can earn, and this savings applies to every vehicle on your policy. Call 1-844-530-9771 to learn more. Switch to Liberty Mutual and you could save up to $509. Call Liberty Mutual for a free quote today. at 1-844-530-9771. See car insurance in a whole new light. Liberty Mutual Insurance.
Currently in our area, 77 degrees under fair skies. Tonight, clear to partly cloudy, low 73. Winds light and variable. Saturday, sunshine and clouds mixed, high 84. Winds east-northeast at 10 to 15 miles per hour. Saturday night, clear skies with a few passing clouds, low 73. Winds east at 5 to 10 miles per hour. Here's our 7-day outlook.
Welcome back as we take a look at Austin, Texas. As we follow the historic Texas flooding that has been taking place, we saw quite a bit of rain in and around the city. And that's what's prompted flash flood warning. That is still in effect here for us in and across the city through this evening here. So one of those days where we're watching those rivers and the streams very, very closely as we head through this nighttime hour. All right, let's talk about what's going on the radar. And the good news is at least the heaviest of the rain has really shifted out of the Austin area, although there are a few light showers trying to develop here right along Interstate 35. But we do have, again, that flash flood warning out until 10:15 there. So still having to deal with that. And you can see some of the heavy rain that we've dealt with. This is over the past 12 hours. And the bulk of this falling earlier today, but we're talking estimated rainfall totals getting up over 7 inches. And that kind of rainfall can cause issues. In fact, we've had in Garfield there, just south and east of Austin, an active water rescue there on Tucker Hill Lane. This is just from the last within the last couple of hours. So you can see that we still have issues there for us in and around Austin. And Kelly, we're going to be watching these spots all throughout the night.
It's one thing to see it on the radar screen, but then you see the actual images that are coming in from social media. And we've been collecting all that video all day long here at the Weather Channel. We want to share it with you right now, some of the best video and, of course, share the stories that we've seen and heard so far as well, including two people who were trapped in high waters. This is in Hays County in central Texas. Look at that. In Hays County, we did see some deadly and devastating flooding just last May over Memorial Day weekend. And here we are doing it again. People holding on to trees for rescue, bystanders having to help in as well. In fact, emergency workers helping to rescue this woman from high water. This is in the Steeplechase area of Kyle. She was actually driving home from work when her car ended up in those high waters. She screamed for help for about an hour and a half before those people were able to reach her. Nearby residents jumped in to help her as well, and thankfully she's doing okay. I want to give you an idea of the scope of this historic flooding that we've seen in Texas. This is the scene earlier in New Braunfels, a town located between Austin and San Antonio. And this is why the mayor of New Braunfels has signed a disaster declaration. Look at the widespread flooding. That neighborhood just covered in floodwaters out there. So we did have some serious problems. Schools that were cut off by flooding as well. A lot of those low-lying areas under evacuation orders. And that's why the Red Cross has stepped in and set up shelters. In fact, we talked to the Red Cross earlier about 8 shelters across 5 counties. And take a look at this. Water rushing around and into the Creek Haven Inn in Wimberley, Texas. This is one of the places still trying to get over the devastating flooding from 5 months ago. The Blanco River topping its banks, sending water through streets and into buildings. Major flooding, once again, courtesy of over a foot of rain in these areas. And then there was the damage parts of the state saw from apparent tornadoes. National Weather Service will survey some of this damage that you're seeing here in DeHaenis, where we saw roofs ripped from homes. One of at least 5 reports of possible tornadoes, and they started coming in before light this morning. And unfortunately, we're still looking at the threat of more severe weather over tonight and on into the day tomorrow as well.
Yeah, we certainly are, and not what we want to see, that is for sure. We've seen just so much rainfall out there. In fact, as we take a look back at how much we saw in and around San Antonio, it really piled up here for us this morning, particularly north and east of town there for you as you worked away up towards the Wimberley Seattle area, as Kelly mentioned, a spot that has certainly seen its fair share of rain. And over the last 7 days, this whole area here in Texas, and even as you include parts of the lower Mississippi Valley, has seen just an incredible amount of rain. So you can imagine, you add more on what we've seen over the past 7 days, you get all of these storm reports, and they're pretty incredible out there, including around the New Braunfels area, where we saw rainfall accumulation getting up over 8.5 inches there for you. And in Kyle, look at this. We're talking double digits, 16 inches of rain. And Kelly, no doubt that can cause the problem.
So the big question is, do we get a break? I mean, we really need it in Texas from both the severe weather as well as the flooding that we've seen from all the rainfall. We're going to continue to track this for you and keep you ahead of the dangers on this special report. We're with you live till midnight Eastern time.
Before you put any engine to bed this winter, don't drain the fuel tank. Top it off with Stabil storage. It keeps fuel fresh. So come spring, your power equipment is ready to go. And your hog won't be a bore.
Did you know that good nutrition is critical for brain health?
Brain food.
Ensure has B vitamins that help support brain health. Now that's smart nutrition.
Ensure's complete balanced nutrition has 26 vitamins and minerals and 9 grams of protein. Ensure, take life in.
I love you.
Love me too.
One minute. Hi. We need to do this, yes. Be good.
Hi.
Letting go.
I'll say a word.
It's a little easier when you've saved for college with State Farm.
The cold truth is...
Okay, kids, let's go.
No one can really fill your shoes when you're sick. Alka-Seltzer Plus Day Cold and Flu has 3 cold symptom fighters to relieve your tough symptoms. Stay unstoppable. Alka-Seltzer Plus.
I take Prilosec OTC each morning for my frequent heartburn. Because you can't beat... Zero heartburn! Ah, the sweet taste of victory.
Prilosec OTC. One pill each morning, 24 hours, zero heartburn.
If you have moderate to severe plaque psoriasis, isn't it time to let the real you shine through? Introducing Otezla, apremilast. Otezla is not an injection or a cream. It's a pill that treats plaque psoriasis differently. Some people who took Otezla saw 75% clearer skin after 4 months. And Otezla's prescribing information has no requirement for routine lab monitoring. Don't take Otezla if you are allergic to any of its ingredients. Otezla may increase the risk of depression. Tell your doctor if you have a history of depression or suicidal thoughts or if these feelings develop. Some people taking Otezla reported weight loss. Your doctor should monitor your weight and may stop treatment. Side effects may include diarrhea, nausea, upper respiratory tract infection, and headache. Tell your doctor about all the medicines you take and if you're pregnant or planning to be. Ask your doctor about Otezla today. Otezla. Show more of you.
What's this?
A box. I take worn out things and makes them better.
It's our biggest breakthrough yet. We're taking worn out batteries and making them into something strong. Energizer Eco Advanced, world's first long-lasting battery made with 4% recycled batteries.
Why do we insist on 100% Alaskan whitefish?
Why do we always hand dip in our famous batter, cook it to golden perfection, and serve it with fries for just $1.99? Because at Long John Silver's, we think you deserve more for $1.99.
Sunday night, 2 undefeated teams, 2 future Hall of Fame quarterbacks, and only one will remain unbeaten. 2 of the NFL's best square off in the biggest game of the season. Packers, Broncos. Sunday night is football night, only on NBC.
Currently in our area, 77 degrees under fair skies. Tonight, clear to partly cloudy, low 73. Winds light and variable. Saturday, sunshine and clouds mixed, high 84. Winds east-northeast at 10 to 15 miles per hour. Saturday night, clear skies with a few passing clouds, low 73. Winds east at 5 to 10 miles per hour. Here's our 7-day outlook.
It's a horrible day there across the Lone Star State. Half past the hour here on the Weather Channel. I'm Alex Wallace.
And I'm Kelly Cass. Thanks for joining us as we continue to track this very dangerous situation, historic flooding really across Texas. And take a look at this video. It shows you kind of what the state's been dealing with. This is a high school in San Marcos. This is located between Austin and San Antonio.
Yeah, officials actually evacuated the school, and you can see why. The area was actually just surrounded by all sorts of water. There it is there. Unreal. Mm-hmm. That a city under a boil water order because of today's flooding.
And we want to show you also what we've been dealing with as far as, you know, severe weather too in this area. A lot, besides the flooding, we did have tornado reports, really strong thunderstorms moving on through. So no wonder we had evacuations, not just at this particular school, but across many neighborhoods in the central part of Texas.
Yeah, really quite a bit of a mess there across the area. The good news, at least the heaviest of the rain in those areas has really subsided. But again, the damage has been done. The waters are still running pretty high in a lot of these spots. And again, just to make sure you know, there is a boil water order there in San Marcos. Now, Austin is one of the places that has gotten deluged today. More than a foot of rain there earlier today by the city's airport.
Just incredible. Joining us right now is Paul Ura with the Austin San Antonio Office of the National Weather Service. What a day you guys have had out there, Paul. Thanks so much for joining us. The radar looking a little bit quiet right now, but are you still concerned about going through the overnight hours?
Yeah, we're actually very concerned. The problem that we're having, of course, all the models have been showing activity to try to redevelop and refire overnight, especially over across our western areas. And of course, that looks like it's happening now. So the unfortunate part is that it looks like a lot of the areas that got rain earlier today are probably going to be getting more rain overnight. Hopefully it's not as much rain, but of course, the ground can't take any rain right now. So we're definitely going to be on high alert overnight, and everybody has to be just aware to more flooding, especially across the I-35 corridor where they did have over a foot of rain.
Now, Paul, how much do you anticipate in addition to what you've already seen?
Right now, I think we're hoping for only a few inches of rain. I think there could be a couple of spots that could get upwards of 4 or 5 inches. I think these thunderstorms with the main trough coming through are probably going to be moving a little bit faster than the storms earlier today. So we're hopeful we can get out through the night without actually only getting a couple more inches.
Yeah, we're recapping the day, just kind of looking back on this event, what took place, all the ingredients that kind of led to this flood. I mean, we're talking incredible totals that have really put you guys in record territory. We're talking the record wettest month on record, is that right?
Right, and also in Austin, it's the wettest day on record as well, with over 14 inches of rain. So there was a large area actually all along Interstate 35 in between New Braunfels and Austin that got well over a foot. And unfortunately, all that has led to some very large flooding issues, not so different than what we had back on a Halloween event that we had actually 2 years ago, almost to the day. So we live in Flash Flood Alley, where we're kind of used to this sort of environment, especially in October where we get big flood events. But unfortunately, they're coming a little bit more often than I'd like.
Wow. That's for sure.
Yeah, absolutely. And Paul, as we look towards the future, when do we anticipate to see things finally clear out?
Well, I think all the models have been pretty persistent in bringing the front and bringing the trough through by early Saturday morning. So we're very hopeful that this will, you know, we can just hopefully deal with this for another 12 hours or so. And then by tomorrow morning, everything will be clearing out, at least pushing further to the east. We will have a lot of residual flooding, most likely. We'll have to be dealing with river flooding for the next several days, probably. But hopefully we'll get at least the flash flood concern out of our area.
All right, Paul Eura, thank you so much for joining us with the National Weather Service. You guys have been on top of it. I know you have all day long, been busy, and we'll continue to track this this situation as we go through the overnight hours because we're not even done yet.
Yeah, absolutely. As you mentioned, you know, even once the rain stops, the threat is not done. You still have those rivers that it takes a while for the water to finally get into those rivers, and they keep coming up.
We want to toss it over now to our storm specialist, Carl Parker, joining us here in the lab. And Carl, you know, he really put it in perspective for us as far as the record, but a lot of things went into this.
A lot of things went into this. You're right. You're talking about a lot of low-level moisture coming from the Gulf of Mexico, but then also mid-level moisture coming out of the Pacific Ocean, where we've got a lot of it available because the water temperatures have been so warm. El Nino, to some extent, contributing to the amount of moisture in the atmosphere that was drawn in by this big system, and you've got a slow-moving system on top of that. Let's talk about how much rain we got. There's the one-day rainfall. This is not as widespread as last week's event was, but where it came down, it really came down. We'll zoom in on the area along I-35 there between Austin and San Antonio, and this is where we've had those double-digit rainfall totals, and the result was just devastating flooding earlier today. You see the flash flooding that occurred on the Guadalupe River. This is a very popular spot for tubing there in Texas, and you see how quickly that came up from just a couple of feet to 22 feet in the space of just a few hours there, and then it dropped as quickly. So at least there things are improving. And then looking at the Leon Creek here in San Antonio, now at 19.9, the forecast crest 21 feet, and that is in major stage, but it should come down pretty rapidly tomorrow. So looking at the radar picture right now, you notice the flash flood warnings that are ongoing along 35 and farther eastward. We've had some showers there tonight, but again, as we just heard from the National Weather Service, there is some concern that we'll see more rain overnight tonight. We've been watching this cell there just west of I-10. A new warning issued on that, by the way, and that's a severe warning for Bandera Care and Real counties going until 10:30. Watching out for some large hail and possible damaging wind along with that storm. And then here northward into the Metroplex, we've watched a line of storms approaching, and that line of storms is now not as intense as it once was. So there is less of a severe threat, but more of a flash flooding threat as that rain is beginning to spread out and run across a lot of the same areas, especially there between Dallas and Fort Worth, right around Garland. So here's the broader picture. You've got this big upper low, moisture feeding in from the Gulf of Mexico, high level moisture feeding in from the southwest there, and all of that only very slowly moving along. So again, another round of wet weather is on the way, and there are a couple of areas we'll need to watch. We're going to want to watch the I-35 corridor because we've had so many problems already today, but then also southeast Texas, where we expect to see quite a bit of rain coming through over the next several hours. So here's the future radar. This is a model forecast. Here's that possible complex developing overnight tonight coming up towards 35. A lot of heavy rain there around Orange County, Port Jefferson, and also into Beaumont there, Lake Charles. And then we expect to see a good bit of wet weather around the Piney Woods and northeast Texas. And this is going to go even into tomorrow morning. And then finally, during the morning hours, Kelly, we expect the rain to clear out of I-35, but still be going on in parts of Louisiana and southeast Texas. Over to you.
Carl, thanks so much. Devastating impacts from this flooding. Here's what we know at this hour. At least two deaths so far from this deluge, one in the Austin area, the other near San Antonio. The mayor of New Braunfels has issued a disaster declaration for his town. In San Marcos, the city is under a boil water order as a result of all the flooding. And 2.5-hour ground stop delays reported at Dallas-Fort Worth International. Luffield also getting in on some of those delays and ground stops because of the thunderstorms in your area. We're going to track that rain where it's headed next, but you can see where we still have the ongoing flash flood threats. It's not just about Texas. We're talking about many parishes here in southern Louisiana and getting into extreme southwestern Mississippi as well. As we track that heavy rain leaving the Lone Star State, moving through Louisiana as we go into the weekend, there's Saturday night, wrap up that trick-or-treating because it looks like that wet weather is going to be rolling on in, and look at those big storms ending up on the Florida beaches by Sunday afternoon. Alex?
All right. Well, you know, the state's also struggling with damage from apparent tornadoes on the way. We'll hear from a student rocked awake by one of them earlier today, and we'll show you who's at risk for storm trouble the rest of tonight and as we head into the weekend.
Currently in our area, 77 degrees under fair skies. Tonight, clear to partly cloudy, low 73. Winds light and variable. Saturday, sunshine and cloudy. Saturday night, clear skies with a few passing clouds, low 73. Winds east at 5 to 10 miles per hour. Here's our 7-day outlook.
If my hands are dried and cracked, I can't do my job efficiently.
My hands are dry from washing my hands lots of times a day.
O'Keefe's Working Hands. Guaranteed relief for dry, cracked hands.
O'Keefe's works.
I saw it working for my husband, and I knew I had to try it.
Learn more at O'Keefe'sCompany.com.
Hi, I'm Tony Romo, and I have DirecTV.
And I'm arts and craftsy Tony Romo, and I have cable.
Only DirecTV's NFL Sunday Ticket lets you watch every single game live from start to finish.
With cable, you don't get every game, so I channel my frustrations using papier-mâché.
I can pick out any game I want to watch from the 8-game mix.
I mixed a cupcake and a brownie. I'm calling it a crownie.
Don't be like this, me. Get NFL Sunday Ticket only on DirecTV. Call 1-800-DIRECTV.
What's this?
A box. It takes worn-out things and makes them better.
It's our biggest breakthrough yet. We're taking worn-out batteries and making them into something strong. Energizer Eco Advanced, world's first long-lasting battery made with 4% recycled batteries.
If you have moderate to severe rheumatoid arthritis like me, and you're talking to your rheumatologist about a biologic, this is Humira. This is Humira helping to relieve my pain and protect my joints from further damage. This is Humira giving me new perspective. Doctors have been prescribing Humira for 10 years. Humira works for many adults. It targets and helps to block a specific source of inflammation that contributes to RA symptoms.
Humira can lower your ability to fight infections, including tuberculosis. Serious, sometimes fatal infections and cancers, including lymphoma, have happened, as have blood, liver, and nervous system problems, serious allergic reactions, and new or worsening heart failure. Before treatment, get tested for TB. Tell your doctor if you've been to areas where certain fungal infections are common, and if you've had TB, hepatitis B, are prone to infections or have flu-like symptoms or sores. Don't start Humira if you have an infection.
Talk to your doctor and visit Humira.com. This is Humira at Work.
Did you know only 1% of supplements have earned the USP mark? An independent certification for quality and purity. I recommend Nature Made because they've earned the most of any brand.
Nature Made, the number one pharmacist recommended letter vitamin brand.
Trick or treat! Thank you!
Tonight we come to let loose.
It's a very little thing.
Tonight we come to dance. Tonight we change things.
Freedom. Freedom.
When I lay in my Tempur-Pedic contour, then I slowly feel it start to kind of wrap itself around me. And the next thing I know, it's morning.
With Tempur-Flex, you've got the spring and bounce of a traditional mattress. Then it also adjusts to my body.
My cloud feels so comfortable. It feels like somebody's hugging you. How can a bed do that?
There's a Tempur-Pedic for everyone. Find the feel that's right for you.
To sleep happy guaranteed and 0% APR financing, visit Mattress Firm, America's number one Tempur-Pedic retailer.
Wow.
Mm-hmm. Indeed, the storm's also packing quite a bit of lightning.
Yeah, you just saw it there and heard it. It actually hit a Doppler radar tower in Brownsville, Texas earlier today. That's in deep south Texas. We're talking right near the border with Mexico. Wow.
Yeah, you could almost feel it here just by through the video itself. Incredible stuff for sure. Now, visitors and residents alike stunned by the storms that we've seen today and the damage that they have caused.
Yeah, when it comes to today's tornadoes in Texas, this really is the iconic image. I mean, look at that tractor trailer that was basically picked up, we think, from a nearby road, and at least part of it ending up on a hotel here in Floresville.
Yeah, I mean, a pretty amazing sight, no doubt. I mean, just goes to show you the power of the wind out there, and all indications are probably talking about a tornado here that caused that that damage and lifted that truck. An amazing sight.
Yeah, the National Weather Service, they'll be surveying that damage to determine exactly what happened here, but we've got our own expert as well. Severe weather expert Dr. Greg Forbes pieced together what could have happened and suggested just how strong this tornado might be in a discussion with our own Ray Stajic.
Clearly a tractor trailer, a semi had been hit somewhere adjacent to that hotel there. You see now as they pan out some a lot of trucks and buildings there off to the right of the hotel where's probably where the tornado hit. Maybe the tractor trailer was on that road there, was picked up, tossed in the air, and then centrifuged out of the tornado, hurled out of the tornado circulation. The tractor trailer unable to follow the tight counterclockwise winds around the tornado and landed on the roof. Clearly not a tremendous amount of damage there to the hotel that we could see, but I would think that we're talking about probably at least an EF2 tornado damage somewhere in the adjacent areas to this. The National Weather Service will go out and examine and find the strongest type of structure. There is not, by the way, a way to rate a tornado based upon just the tossing of tractor trailers like that, so they'll have to look at structures that were hit by it in the vicinity of where the tractor trailer may have been. Right,
Greg. Any possibility that are we definitely thinking tornado here, or could straight line winds or something else do something to that magnitude?
Well, typically straight line winds, when they're straight line winds, the winds are coming downward, so usually they don't have that kind of lifting that would have lifted a tractor trailer up two or three stories high. So I'm 99% sure that had to have been done by a tornado, which does have that inflowing winds, and then in addition to the counterclockwise rotation, it has those strong upward going winds, and that's what can pick up vehicles, pick up things as big as a tractor trailer and toss it through the air.
Incredible. Now, Floresville, just one of the places where an apparent tornado struck today in Texas. DeHaines and Geronimo, that's just southeast of San Marcos, dealt with possible tornadoes as well. And possible tornadoes were also reported 3 miles east, northeast of Hunter in Hays County, and 8 miles west of Caldwell in Burleson County. Well, Kelly's standing by now to pinpoint where the severe weather concern is now and what we have to look forward to into the weekend.
We're not even done with the threat here in Texas. We still have several counties here in the western part of the state under a severe thunderstorm watch until 2 o'clock in the morning central time. It does not include San Antonio, but we are starting to see some of those storms firing up not too far from San Antonio, and we're still concerned about Austin. You're catching a little bit of a break right now, but we're thinking heavy rain is going to move back into this already saturated area. Lots of lightning going with storms in a line from Dallas stretching back towards San Angelo. We'll zoom in on Dallas right now because we are experiencing a ground stop at the airport. You can see why. Very heavy rain pounding the area. There could be a little bit of street flooding going on, although no official flash flood warnings are in effect right now. We'll keep an eye on this for sure, but at least we're not looking at severe weather here. You head west of Fort Worth, though, and west of Stephenville. This is where we do have an active severe thunderstorm warning. We're talking portions of Eastland County until 10:15 central time. Those areas around Carbon, also Gorman, Rising Star, there could be some really strong winds, better than 60 miles per hour, maybe even some hail with that storm as well. And really strong winds as we head down south here into Bandera, Kerr, and Real counties. You have a severe thunderstorm warning until 10:30 central time, and this storm does have a history of producing damaging wind gusts. We're talking about an 82 mile per hour gust in Brackettville, so take these warnings seriously. Just as you would a tornado warning, get away from the windows. And Austin, you are still under a flash flood warning. And look at that, Alex. We've got more showers developing right there in that area.
All right, Kelly. Well, these storms in Texas certainly causing a misery for some who are unfortunately no strangers to the damage flooding can do.
Numerous swift water rescues. At this stage of the game, there are no reports of any type of injuries or fatalities. Multiple vehicles lost, water in a number of businesses. It truly was a gut check.
Along the way, what this latest flooding has done in the community of Wimberley, residents and visitors share their stories.
Wow, this toilet paper reminds me of a washcloth.
New Charmin Ultra Strong, dude. Cleans so well, it keeps your underwear cleaner. So clean, you could wear them a second day.
Oh, tell me, I did not just hear that.
I said you could, not that you would.
New Charmin Ultra Strong with its washcloth-like texture helps clean better than the leading flat-textured Bargain brand. It's 4 times stronger, and you can use up to 4 times less.
It cleans better. You should try it, Skids.
We all go. Why not enjoy the go with Charmin?
How to make an awesome weather science show. Take 3 scientists.
That's us.
Yeah, scientists. Yeah. They know that.
Add the forces of nature.
Woo, that's hot stuff.
Mix in some crazy experiments.
Lit my hand on fire.
Why?
Because of science.
Oh, that is so cool.
And then...
Go!
Who said science isn't fun?
3 scientists walk into a bar. Bottoms up Sunday nights at 10 on the Weather Channel. And join the community now on Facebook.com/3scientists.
Currently in our area, 77 degrees under fair skies. Tonight, clear to partly cloudy, low 73. Winds light and variable. Saturday, sunshine and clouds mixed, high 84. Winds east-northeast at 10 to 15 miles per hour. Saturday night, clear skies with a few passing clouds, low 73. Winds east at 5 to 10 miles per hour. Here's our 7-day outlook.
I don't want to live with the uncertainties of Hep C.
Or wonder whether I should seek treatment.
I am ready.
Because today, there's Harvoni, a revolutionary treatment for the most common type of chronic hepatitis C. Harvoni is proven to cure up to 99% of patients who've had no prior treatment. It's the one and only cure that's one pill once a day for 12 weeks. Certain patients can be cured with just 8 weeks of Harvoni. With Harvoni, there's no interferon, and there are no complex regimens. Tell your doctor if you have other liver or kidney problems or other medical conditions, and about all the medicines you take, including herbal supplements. Harvoni should not be taken with any medicines containing amiodarone, rifampin, or St. John's wort. It also should not be taken with any other medicine that contains Sovaldi. Side effects may include tiredness and headache.
I am ready to put Hep C behind me.
I am ready to be cured.
Are you ready? Ask your Hep C specialist if Harvoni is right for you.
Wow, sweet new Subaru, huh, Mitch?
Yep.
You're selling the Mitchmobile?
Man, we had a lot of good times in this baby. What'd your dad want for it?
Like 150 grand.
200 if they want that tape deck.
You're not gonna tell your dad about the time my hamster had babies in the back seat, are you? That's just normal wear and tear, dude.
Subaru has the highest resale value of any brand, according to Kelley Blue Book. And Mitch. Love. It's what makes it.
Great time for a shiny floor wax, no? Not if you just put the finishing touches on your latest masterpiece. Timing's important. Comcast Business knows that. That's why you can schedule an installation at a time that works for you, even late at night or on the weekend if that's what you need, because you have enough to worry about. I did not see that coming.
Don't deal with disruptions. Get better internet installed on your schedule. Comcast Business, built for business.
Let's give them a great breakfast so they can go out there and kick the butt they came here to kick. The reason they hired me is because I care about the details. I care so much it hurts.
Huh?
It's the little things that make your stay awesome, like free breakfast and pancake technology that I'm pretty sure we stole from the space program. One button, hot pancake. Total victory!
Thursdays on the Weather Channel. When nature is this dangerous, only one question matters.
Oh my God!
So you think you'd survive? Thursdays at 10, only on the Weather Channel.
Well, this is what it looked like earlier today in the town of Kyle, Texas. You can barely see the tires of this truck. Incredible water surrounding homes. They look like islands after more than 16 inches. Yes, 16 inches of rain fell here. And this is a reminder that the rain could be headed to places that are already swamped. These are pictures from Laura Rose showing the flooding that hit Monday in Albany, Louisiana. And she says that it still looks like this in her town. Not much of that water has receded. And that's not a good situation because all this wet weather is going to be moving its way east eventually and moving its way into Louisiana. But right now, we still have it in Texas. A spot dealing with some of the rain right now is actually Dallas, the Fort Worth Metroplex area. A line of showers and storms that is slowly moving its way through the area. No flood warnings on any of these storms. No severe warnings, but certainly some heavy downpours moving on through right now. We've had ground stops for us in Dallas at both of the airports there. Farther south in Austin, we still are under a flash flood warning there. That's until 10:15 local time there for you. The good news is at least the heaviest rain has really ceased there for us, but there is a line of showers, fairly light, just adding insult to injury here from some of the heavy rain that we saw earlier today. Kelly?
Well, this flooding has proven deadly, unfortunately. Two people have died, one in Austin, the other in the San Antonio area. The storm bringing that flooding started early this morning in Texas, and as they continue to rumble across the state, NBC's Janet Shamlian tracks the damage we've seen so far.
It's been a major storm here in Texas, massive flooding in parts of the state, and evacuations as roads are turning into rivers.
Violent storms battering south central Texas, record rain, reports of tornadoes, flooding, and widespread damage. Evacuations from San Antonio to Austin.
There's one of our vehicles that got washed away.
Near the town of Wimberley, Kathleen Haney and her friends were trapped in a bed and breakfast until rescued by the National Guard.
We didn't know where we were going. It was dark, and the water was rising so fast.
Warned of the danger as the Cypress River spilled over its banks and raced towards homes and businesses. On Halloween Eve, the roads were filled with pumpkins carried away by the storm. In Austin, a mess. Amid the rising water, this driver helped from her vehicle by passersby.
I quickly rolled down the window and just pulled myself up.
A possible tornado in the community of Floresville left this in its wake. A tractor trailer, like a broken toy, atop a hotel. Power lines down everywhere. The roof ripped from a high school. In South Texas, a lightning strike knocked out radar at the National Weather Service in Brownsville. Rain soaked the state, closing the Austin airport, which was battered by almost 14 inches in 6 hours, more than the city received the entire month of May, which was already the second wettest on record. The swollen Blanco River, cresting more than 13 and a half feet over flood stage.
Stop watching it come up, please look down.
The evacuations along the riverbank reminiscent of May, when storms claimed 31 lives, including 8 people in a home that was swept down the river.
It went from nothing to up my driveway.
Elisa Prado was pregnant then. Late today, she was rescued with her 10-day-old baby.
Second time, you know? This is the second time this happened to us. It's almost unbelievable.
All eyes are on the Blanco River here and other rivers in the central part of the state because another round of storms could be on the way. Janet Shamlian, NBC News, San Marcos, Texas.
Wow, and as you just saw, Wimberley, Texas, especially stunned by this latest round of flooding.
Yeah, the community was hit so very hard almost 5 months ago, so a lot of people are still trying to rebuild after the flooding that we saw over Memorial Day weekend. At least 27 people died in central Texas after relentless rain sent the Blanco River and other waterways out of their banks. Wimberley, hard hit, and now dealing with more flooding. And the aftermath yet again.
And you know, this historic flooding in Texas, just the very latest example of what has been a truly wild week.
It's been busy, a week of record-setting high tides. We've had destructive and damaging winds, and then, of course, the rain.
Just like the wind was going to blow you over.
I mean, the winds have been nuts.
You can really see just how rough this surf is and how nasty, too.
That is an angry ocean right there.
Great example of how you don't know what's under the road. Either they drove off the road or part of the road gave out.
Were you frightened?
Oh, yeah. Yes, I was.
Oh, my God!
Currently in our area, 77 degrees under fair skies. Tonight, clear to partly cloudy, low 73. Winds light and variable. Saturday, sunshine and clouds mixed, high 84. Winds east-northeast at 10 to 15 miles per hour. Saturday night, clear skies with a few passing clouds, low 73.